Hi, I'm Cathy with LoveLabRN. In this video, I'm going to continue my coverage of topics from our LoveLabRN nutrition flashcard deck. Specifically, I'll be talking about nutritional guidance for select respiratory disorders, including COPD, cystic fibrosis, and tuberculosis. And at the end of the video, I'm going to give you guys a quiz to test your understanding of some of the key points I'll be covering. So definitely stay tuned for that. And if you have our nutrition flashcards, go ahead and pull out your flashcard on respiratory disorders so you can follow along with me. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, is a chronic lung disease that causes airway obstruction. COPD includes two main conditions, which are emphysema and chronic bronchitis. Individuals with COPD exert a lot of energy just to breathe, and often have difficulty eating due to shortness of breath. Therefore, many patients with COPD are malnourished. It is recommended that individuals with COPD consume a high-calorie, high-protein diet. They should also consume small, frequent meals and rest before meals to help with shortness of breath. And then increased fluid intake is also recommended to help thin the respiratory secretions. Next, we're going to talk about cystic fibrosis, which is an autosomal recessive disorder that results in abnormally thick, sticky mucus that plugs organ ducts and results in breathing issues, pancreatic dysfunction, and malabsorption issues. Individuals with cystic fibrosis have two times the energy needs of other individuals. So a high-fat, high-calorie, high-protein diet is recommended. Pancreatic enzymes need to be taken with meals and snacks to help with digestion, and fat-soluble vitamin supplementation is typically required as well. So this is vitamin A, D, E, and K. And then lastly, individuals with cystic fibrosis lose more salt with their sweat and are at increased risk for dehydration, so increased intake of salt and fluids is typically advised. And lastly, let's talk briefly about tuberculosis, or TB. TB is an infectious disease of the lungs that results in a persistent cough, bloody sputum, night sweats, and fatigue. It also causes decreased appetite, weight loss, and malnutrition. Therefore, a high-calorie, high-protein, nutrient-dense diet is recommended for patients with tuberculosis. All right, it's quiz time. Are you guys ready? Question number one. Individuals with COPD are advised to eat small, frequent meals and rest before meals. True or false? The answer is true. Question number two. When should a patient with cystic fibrosis take pancreatic enzymes? The answer is with meals and snacks. Question number three. How should protein and calorie intake be adjusted for an individual with tuberculosis? The answer is they should be increased. All right, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Take care and thank you so much for watching.
We invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. And if you found value in this video, be sure to hit that like button and let us know what you found to be particularly helpful.